Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
At this time, we're going to go ahead and get our service started for today.
Amen.
Amen. At this time, we're going to have our scripture read by Missionary McFadden.
All right.
And following the scripture, prayer will be by Minister E. Mitchell.
Can we all stand, please? I will be reading Proverbs, the 31st chapter, starting at the 28th verse. Her children arise up and call her blessed. Her husband also, and he praise her. Many daughters have done virtually, but thou say exceedingly them all. Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord shall be praised. Give her of the fruits of her hands, and let her own work praise her in her gates.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. We're going to go to God in prayer. God, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, it's once more again. God, we come, God, just as humble as we know how. God, we come with a repentant heart, oh God, to your very throne of grace and mercy, oh God. Asking now, God, Father, that you first forgive us, oh God, for all sins, oh God. God, anything, God, that we may have done that will cause a separation between us and you, oh God. Oh God, we ask for your forgiveness now in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, we ask as we enter into this holy sanctuary, oh God. God, to lift up the name of Jesus. Oh God, to put our hands together, to open up our mouth, God, and to give God some praise. We will do as David said, when he said, I will bless the Lord at all times, as his praises shall continually be in my mouth. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, we come to celebrate, oh God. We come to give thanks, oh God. We come to bless your name, oh God, for the lady of this house, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, we ask you all this afternoon, God, to have thine own way, oh God. Sup with us just for a little while, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, Holy Ghost, move like you moved this morning, God. Move on this afternoon, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, shipwreck this place, oh God, with your anointing, God. Shipwreck this place, oh God, with your power, God. Send forth your anointing, God, that makes preaching easy, God. Bless your woman servant, God, that will give a word in this house, oh God. Strengthen our body, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we will give you praise, God. We will give you glory, God. We'll give you honor, God. We'll do our dance, God. We go, oh God, we'll tell you thank you, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, we honor your name, God. Heaven and earth adore you. We searched all over, God. We didn't find nobody, God. Nobody great, oh God. Nobody great, oh God. Nobody great, oh God. We love you this afternoon, God. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, we praise you, oh God. We honor you, oh God. And from this point forth, God, we'll give you the praise. We'll give you the glory. We'll give you the honor. In the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, have that only, oh God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name. And the people of God said, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We come to praise God on this afternoon. Amen. We had a wonderful time on this morning. Amen. So at this time, we're going to go forth with our praise and worship.
Lord. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. We come to celebrate on today. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the worship. Amen. We ask everyone to stand. We come to praise and worship the Lord. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Look at somebody that shout, help me praise the Lord.
Help me praise the Lord.
Come on, look at smiles and say, help me praise the Lord.
Help me praise the Lord.
Come on, look at smiles and say, help me praise the Lord.
Help me praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on, from the rising of the sun, the name of the Lord is to be praised. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah. Come on. We'll be right back. smile on your face. You look much better when you smile. Yes, Lord. The song says, listen, we praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. From the rising of the sun to the setting of the same, we praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. Come and sing, we praise you.
We praise you, Lord.
We praise you, Lord.
Thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Come on, somebody say he's good. thanks unto the Lord, yes. Come on,
give thanks
to the Lord. I want you to look at at somebody and I want you to tell them, amen, look at them. You have to look at them. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You might not know them and they may not know you. I want you to just look at them. Look at them real good. Tell them, say, look at them, look at them, say, brother or sister, say, brother or sister, whatever they are to them. Say, you look good. And say, brother or sister, I know it took a lot to get here today. And tell them, I know it took a lot to get to this day today. But look at them and say, neighbor. Somebody, you know, now, I'm giving y'all permission to preach. Because see, some of y'all want to preach anyway. So I'm trying to give you some. I'm giving you a piece of license today. You got to tell them. Look at them. Say, neighbor. Oh, neighbor. I'm so glad I don't look like what I've been through. That's why. I'm so glad I don't look like what I've been through. I was stressed this month, but I'm so glad. I'm so glad I don't look like what I've been through. People already getting on my nerves this year. I'm so glad I don't look like what I've been through. Yeah, Lord. You made out of a nation. You really gave the tall the snares. Y'all know about that. I have already come. But I'm so glad I don't look like what I've been through. Truly, I'm supposed to be in the nut house. I'm supposed to be on some medicine right now. But I'm so glad. I said, I'm so glad. Thank God I got the Holy Ghost. Yes! The Holy Ghost. People get tired of me talking about the Holy Ghost. But the Holy Ghost is a keeper. Uh-oh, if you want to be careful. He'll keep you in perfect peace. Yes, Lord, if you're mine. Stand on. Come on, lift your hands all over the building. Y'all want to church. Thank you, Jesus. Lift your head all over the building. Come on, say something to the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I've got to your shininess. He kept us. We're about to go into another month. Can I help you? Somebody's about to bury a loved one. But that's not my story. Somebody in the hospital right now almost about to close their eyes. But that's not my story. Millions didn't make it. Good God Almighty. Evangelist Janice, many didn't make it. Didn't make it to today, but I'm so glad. I don't look like it. But God keep Tosha, but God help me. Music make it, but I am one of the ones. I think I got my. I, I,
50 of y'all are here. About 75 out of 100 of y'all are here. We are one of the ones that did. That's why I'm telling you, when you look at my beautiful wife, there's a story behind our praise. Oh God, God, thank you. You might look out, look on the outside, but you don't know the story. I could have been buried. I could have had a funeral for my wife. But God. Y'all, I don't come to church to be cute. I don't put it on if I want to mess it up. But I got the power to bless the Lord at all times. Hallelujah. All right. Let me help some of y'all. This ain't no show for me. Every time I come into church, I'm sweating to give God all of me. Because I know that, glory to God, this might be my last time. And Lord, if you're taking me right now, I'm ready. And I'm going out with a praise. Somebody shout yes. Your hands all in the building. I'm gonna be singing. Church that you feel the presence of the Lord. Come on. Oh baby, look at somebody say, we free in here. No longer, man. No more chains holding me. I'm free. Yay. Lift your hands all over the building. He's out straight today. We're going to our seat. Thank you, Jesus. Get somebody say it's gonna reach to you today. It reaches to you. Come on. It reaches. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your voices and say, you are my strength. My strength. Come on. Strength life. No other. Like the water.
And it reaches to me. You are my joy. In the fullness,
if you need choice in the world today,
reaches.
now. My Savior. Y'all remember the old songs. I come.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Yes, Lord! said be beautiful, y'all. Amen. A humble servant, inside and out. Amen. A gift from God. Amen. I love what it does. Amen. Woo! Glory to God. One thing I know known about her, she do love to praise God. Amen. So y'all come on. Give with the service. Amen. So you miss it, that's on you. I'm not coming back to this point. I gotta keep going on. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. So now, oh, we gotta praise Him. Anybody gonna help her praise Him? We'll be right back. Amen. Before I go any further with the program, amen, we like to give honor to our apostle, Love from Clinton. Try to move right along with the service. Amen. Our welcome is on the... Amen. Our welcome will be coming from our minister Stackhouse. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
I'm here to do an easy task, and that's welcome you to City of Praise Ministries to our leading ladies celebration service. We thank you all for coming. If you need anything, let one of the members know. We can direct you either way you need, whatever you need. I just ask that you get with the service, praise God, and let's just celebrate our lady, right?
Amen. For that welcome. Amen. Next, we're going to have our ministry of dance by our missionary, Jayla. All
Thank you.
truth. So anytime the devil tells me I'm not something, I always say I am.
So much for that ministry in there. Amen. Amen. So now we're going to keep moving along.
Amen.
Amen. Words of Encouragement by Evangelist Fonda Jones.
Oh, come on, bless the Lord, everybody. Come on, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, all my soul. And all that sits within me, bless his holy name. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the name of the Lord shall be praised. Don't stop me if you are coming. I got an assignment. Praise the Lord. But I feel good in my sanctified soul. Amen. Giving honor to this great leader, my big brother. Amen, Apostle Love, amen. Amen, my sister, amen, the leading lady of this house, amen. Hallelujah, I thank y'all for being in greetings from Greater Higher Grounds, Pentecostal Holiness Church of Deliverance Incorporated by the great Apostle Clifton Lee Campbell, amen. Thank you, Jesus, thank God, amen, for my big sister, Pastor Erica, that's going to release a rhema word in this place. Amen, I have an easy task, amen. And when brother asked me to give you words of encouragement, I kept pondering. I said, but Lord, what can I say to her that I don't already say? And he said to tell you to stay the course.
All right.
He said, tell her that as she is entering into her birth month, that he is going to give her another birth.
Right.
He said, stay the course. And then he said to tell you these simple words, the tables will turn. Y'all don't have to get it, it's for her. He said to tell you that the tables will turn. And he gave me the snippet of that song and he said, you don't have to worry. You don't have to cry no more. I've been in church all week. Wipe the tears from your eyes. It's gonna be alright. That's what they told me to tell you. You don't have to worry. You don't have to cry no more. The next set of tears gonna be tears of joy. Wipe the tears from your eyes. It's gonna be alright. That's what they told me to tell you, sis. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. Why is my miracle the gift of returning your favor? It's gonna be alright. Yeah. It's gonna be alright. I love you. God bless you. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
All right, now it's time for our ministry of giving.
Yeah.
Woo, woo!
Amen. Amen. We're going to be taking up receiving two offerings on today. Amen. Our first offering will be for our elect lady. Amen. City of Praise, you already know what to do. Amen. If you don't have cash, she does have a cash app. And also, we will be taking up a speaker's offering on today.
Amen. Come on, praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, it's time to give money. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Amen. I come to help with the offer. If you're going to give by the way of Cash App, it is $Carolyn 2258. Again, that's Carolyn 2258. And please let us see that you sent the money. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we're going to start this offering off with $120. Amen. Amen. You can stand on your feet. Okay, so we're going to have this side start from the back, turn towards the center aisle, and come from the rear. Amen. If I can have everybody come around and give me, we need to reach a goal. Amen. 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 So I'm going to give $50 more.
Amen.
So whenever you have what you have, can you stand on your feet and come again? Goal, amen. Amen. Give yourself a hand. Amen. So now we're getting ready to receive our preacher's offering. Amen. Amen. We are now going to receive our preacher's offering. Amen. Amen. Dollar sign Pastor Erikia. Uh-huh. Yeah, I got that. So that's dollar sign Pastor Erikia. Don't ask me how to spell it, but I'm a mess. So again, can this side please stand? Can everybody please stand? You fight on. God. And you got everybody please stand.
Call up Sister Shelby Johnson to introduce our preacher.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Apostle, love, I honor you. Lady Love, I honor you as well. Happy birthday. I stand before you today to introduce the speaker of the hour. She is the pastor of the Prevailing Church of Lumberton, North Carolina. She is married to Apostle Patrick McNair, which I honor in his absence on today. Together they have four children, but she mothers us all. She has been preaching for over 18 years, and her call to the ministry is to help the wounded. I thank God for her because I truly believe that she lives the life that she preaches about. And as she comes today, I ask that you pray for her, that God will give to her what she is to give to us in her own unique way. I present to some and introduce to others, Pastor Erykia McNair.
Amen, amen. Right before she comes, y'all, City of Praise is going to give us a selection.
All right.
Amen. All right, come on, praise him quickly. Amen.
All right, City.
Amen. Come on and give the praise team a hand clap as they come.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Amen. We come. Amen. Anybody ready for the word of the Lord?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I say, anybody ready for the word of the Lord?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. If you're ready, just stand on your feet. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah. As we sing this song. Come on, I want you to clap your hands. Come on. Let me hear you clap. Come on.
Believe.
you, Apostle. I feel like I got a little surge of war. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Happy birthday, sis. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Oh, yeah.
I agree with everybody. She is a great woman.
Oh, yeah.
Is a great woman.
Oh, yes.
And in her quiet, she will talk to you and soothe you and deliver to you the word of God. I'm so blessed that she's not only my sister, but my friend. And she's my dog baby's mom. Happy birthday. I give honor to Apostle Love on tonight. Brother, and he encouraged me, and he splashes me with water often to help hydrate my soul. Give honor to my husband, Apostle P.D. McNair. He's on his way to Virginia. My oldest daughter's grandfather passed away, but he sends his love. I bring you greetings from the Prevailing Church. Hallelujah. We're blessed to be here on tonight. I count it an honor and privilege. I thank God for all of you, all the ministers, to my dear friend, Evangelist Faye. Hallelujah. To all of you, I count it an honor to be here. So on tonight, what we're going to do is we're going to look at a familiar scripture, but I believe you will come out with a different focus from it. We're going to call this one, Happy Birthday, A Woman and a Girl. And what we're going to deal with is we're going to deal with not only the issues of a woman, but the issues of a girl. And then we're not going to just leave the woman and the girl alone, but we're going to insert Jesus Christ. And you're going to see what he is able to do with a woman and a girl. Somebody say a woman and a girl.
A woman and a girl.
A woman and a girl. So we're going to talk about a woman and a girl on tonight, and we're going to go to a familiar passage. We're going to go to Luke the 8th chapter, because Luke the 8th chapter is full of the miraculous things that Jesus Christ can do. When we first step in Luke the 8th chapter, we see that he delivers a demoniac. Oh, somebody wants me to establish who he is. Jesus had such power that when he went and came into the presence of this demoniac and demanded that the demons came out, he asked them who they were, and they didn't say one name. They said, "We are legion." See, you got to know the power of Jesus Christ. And even the demons quaked at his grace. The demons asked that they be sent out into some swine, and they were sent out into the swine, and the swine winded up down. And then he comes into this region. And when he comes into this region in Luke the 8th chapter, around about 40, we get an introduction to the little girl. Read, Shelby, Luke 8, and we're starting at 40.
And it came to pass that when Jesus was returned, the people gladly received him, for they were all waiting for him.
Yes. Now you gotta check this out. These people were waiting for Jesus Christ. What does that tell us when we come into a body of believers? That we gotta be waiting. We gotta be expecting something from Jesus Christ. We don't come and just sit. If we're sinning, you must know that our spirits are leaping. Our spirits are thirsting for Jesus Christ. Read, Shelby.
And behold, there came a man named Jairus, and he was the ruler of the synagogue.
Yes.
And he fell down at Jesus' feet and besought him that he would come into his house.
Yes.
Now, we get introduced to one of the synagogue leaders. Now, what is it about the synagogue leaders at this time? The synagogue leaders at this time really extolled themselves greater than Jesus Christ. But Jesus Christ was one who walked out what he said. So this man was forced to acknowledge this Jesus Christ.
can fulfill.
Yes.
So we have Jairus, and he falls at the feet of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
What am I saying to you? No matter who you are, no matter where you get, don't you ever forget to fall. You say, I can't get down on the ground. Well, let your heart fall. Let your hands fall. Let your head fall in prayer. There's power in a fall. There's power in a fall. When you fall to the right one. I'm not sending you out there to fall. I'm sending you to fall before the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. I am who I am. The well in the middle of the wind. Oh, if you're going to fall, fall before the King. So Jairus recognizes the fact that he has a problem. He's got a little girl, and something has gone wrong with her. Even a king will seek out help if a child is in need. It's interesting that she was 12 years old. Remember, there are 12 tribes. Read, children.
For he had only one daughter, about 12 years of age.
Somebody say only one daughter. Now, when your one daughter, your one child, that one person that you have gets sick. One child. Yeah.
About 12 years of age.
She's about 12 years old. That's young.
Yeah.
That's young. She's just getting, she's in the puberty stage. She's not quite a woman. She's still a girl. That's why we're talking about a woman and a girl.
And she lay a dying.
Uh-oh. The Bible already told us this is his one daughter. And she's dying. Mm-hmm. Have you ever been in a situation where you feel like you're dying?
Come on.
Oftentimes we begin to sympathize with Jairus right here. But who's going to sympathize with the little girl? She lay a dying.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She lay a dying.
Yeah.
Now her father was in good health. His heart was broken and he went to Jesus. But she lay a dying.
Yeah.
Now the scripture tells me in Jeremiah that God says he knew us before he formed us in our mother's womb.
Yeah.
Beloved, you'll have to go back to Genesis and study 2 and 3 and you will see we were created in the spirit first. So even though her physical body was dying, I can only hear her thoughts. God, I knew you before I was formed in my mother's womb. My mama and my daddy are crying for me. I'm scared. I'm a little girl. I thought I had more years than this. I didn't think it was gonna go this way. It wasn't supposed to be like this. God, I need. See, we forget that she lay a dying. At 12 years old, she has the capacity to know that her bodily members are failing her. Jairus, he knows it too. And he knows that in himself there is nothing that he can do to save his daughter. And so here, I believe the believer is forced to acknowledge the fact that there are limitations on us. And it is most necessary for us to bring our issues to Christ.
But as he went, the people thronged him.
It was a bunch of people in the crowd. Because I don't know about y'all, if I would have known Jesus was going to be there, like my throat is going to scratch it today, I would have been fighting through that crowd. Yeah. and this foot is acting up. You know how, you know what I'm saying? I would have been fighting to get to Jesus Christ. The scripture introduced it and told us that they were waiting for him.
And a woman having an issue of blood.
Uh-oh. She's been to interrupt somebody else's story. This ain't her story. A woman with an issue of blood comes up in this story. And I like the book of Luke because Luke was a physician and he tells us about this woman. But a little girl lays a dying. Honey, where you come from? You got an issue and she's done. So somebody would be pushed into a corner, but not Jesus, and think, which one is he going to help?
12 years, which has spent all
the... Wait a minute, you know we can't go past that, because the girl was 12, she'd been going through this thing for 12 years. There's a significance in the 12. So we got to deal with that. She's had this issue of blood for 12 long years. And this girl is dying. But and she's 12. That's right. See, she's 12. And then she's weak in her body because she's been bleeding for 12 years. So somebody might be thinking this girl is dying, but she's thinking, I don't care what I got to do. I've had this issue for 12 years, and I heard somebody say that Jesus was in town. And I know you might not think I'm the one, but today I had a revelation. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. If the little girl could have gotten up, she probably would have been in the crowd. But she lay on her back, dying. When somebody else interrupts your story, where they do that at? Okay, Shelby.
Which had spent all her living upon physicians.
She ain't have no money. She ain't have no money. She ain't have no money. You know why? Because she had spent it going from position to position. What you been spending your money on? She spent hers going to position to position. Who you been going to? She had no more money. She didn't have anything else to give. What does that teach us? We start with Jesus Christ. Because if we start with mankind, we will be given out. She didn't have no money. Read, Shelby.
Neither could be healed of any.
Neither could be healed of any. One text says, and she could by no wise. There was no earthly wisdom that could heal her case. You ever had a problem that the doctors could not heal? You went to the specialist and every ologist that you could, the pulmonologist, the cardiologist, the endocrinologist, every ologist that you could, and nobody could figure out what was going on with you. Nobody could figure out what was happening with you. Then you wind up coming out of work. You don't have the money to pay the copay. That's the situation she was in. There was no wisdom that could heal her, and she ran out of money. We're talking about a woman and a girl, right? The girl is dying on her bed. The woman has come to a place where she's spent out. You ever been spent out? You ever been fed up? You ever gave up? You go from that place, lay a dying, and spit out bleeding. Where do you go from there? What is the step? What is the process? What is the lead?
Be like this.
Came behind him and touched the border of his garment.
Yeah. This is what she did.
This ain't her story. But when you get desperate enough, you don't care what's happening. You get in the position that you can best get in. Read that one more time, she said, what you read.
Came behind him.
She came behind him. Now, I'm just using my imagination. Because people had pronounced all sorts of things on her, and she probably had shame because the custom was to call a woman like that unclean. You ever been called unclean? You ever been the one that everybody looked at? That everybody said, she's not gonna make it. Her mama ain't nothing. She ain't nothing. Her daddy wasn't nothing. Who is her daddy anyway? Have you ever been there when they said, he gonna wind up in prison like his daddy? He gonna be a drunk. His daddy didn't want him, so he gonna be left out on the side of the road. Have you ever had somebody pronounce that you lay a dying before your heart stops beating? Have you ever had somebody take everything you have and you still in need? Now that'll make you fall on your knees. That'll make you fall. Now that's a place where falling is okay. That's a place where you falling, you're in the presence of God. There's been times when I had to fall before God. And I said, I know they're talking, God, but your word says you knew me before you placed me in my mama's womb. Make it come forth. Manifest what you want for me. I was a girl. Now I'm a woman. Now I need to have a name. I need to be classified. I want to be dormant. Preach, Yomi.
And immediately her issue of blood staunched.
So what she did was interrupted this child's story. Every once in a while, you can't worry about everybody else's story. Every once in a while, it's okay to be worried about just you. When you're bleeding, when you're on your knees, when you don't have anything else to give, when the relationship has ended, the person walked out on you, when you're depressed, when you're suicidal, you gotta drop to your knees. You gotta interrupt any story that you can, but you gotta use some manners when you do it. You interrupt and you say, please, Jay. This ain't her story.
Come on, Jesus.
But the Bible says, the Bible says she touched the hem of his garment. She touched the hem of his garment. Woman, what are you doing on the ground touching the hem of his garment? Let me answer for her. By any means necessary, I'm going to get to Jesus. Of his garment. And when she touches the hem of his garment, the Bible says her bleeding stopped.
Thank you, Lord.
My God.
Yes, Lord.
Now the bleeding comes with the stigma. stigma of having fallen and made mistakes. The bleeding comes when people think they know your business and they're talking about you. The bleeding comes when the church hurts you. The bleeding comes when your friend cuts you. But the bleeding stops when you know who to touch. Oh, this thing is possessional. You may say, what was it about the hem of his garment? I got on a garment. They're just threads in a garment. What you don't understand is the garment was on him. The power was in him. So anywhere she could have touched him on the tip of his sandal, her bleeding would have stopped. Why? Because the power of Jesus is all power. Not black power, not white power, not red power, but all power. She touched the hem of his garment. And she had been talked about. Somebody probably saw her and said, she's not even supposed to be in this crowd. Somebody escort her out. Somebody do this, somebody do that. So in order to touch the hem of his garment, that tells me she had to at least be bent over. But in my sanctified mind, I would fall to my knees because I'm a worshiper and I want Jesus any way that I can get it. So now we got a woman with issues from the way she was treated, issues from relationships, issues from being thrown, weapons being thrown at her, issues from her daddy, issues from her brother, issues from this, issues from that. But for one more time in her life, she decided to trust a man named Jesus. And when she touched him, the bleeding stopped immediately. Beloved, just touch it. Don't even think about it. There is no wisdom, no worldly wisdom that can heal what you're dealing with. Just touch it. Touch the hem of his garment. Reach over.
And Jesus said, who touched me?
Now we already know there was a lot of people around. And they had thrown him. Come up here, sis. Come up here, pastor. So we all in the crowd, y'all come up against me. We all in the crowd. Reached up, what it say?
And Jesus said, who touched me?
And Jesus steps out and says, who touched me? And so then somebody steps up, the cute one, steps up.
The cute.
Now it's with me.
When all denied, Peter and they that were with him said,
hold on now, everybody denied it. Jesus said, wait a minute, who touched me? Who touched me? Who is it that touched me? And so Peter and them, just look at your neighbor and say, are you them?
Are you them?
Oh my God.
Look at your next neighbor and say, are you them?
Are you them?
Go ahead, Chef Peter and him.
That were with him said, Master.
Now you gotta say that like him.
Master.
The multitude thronged thee.
The multitude thronged thee.
You gotta have an attitude. Yeah, you got the man.
And pressed thee.
And pressed thee.
And sayest thou.
And sayest thou.
Who touched me?
Who touched thee?
They done asked, Jesus said somebody touched me. Yeah. They got an attitude. All these people in the crowd. The whole church is full. And you're going to ask me who touched you? Jesus said, yeah, I'm going to ask you who touched me. Because when you touched me, I didn't feel nothing. When they touched me, I didn't feel nothing. But somebody touched me in a way that it drew my fracture for me. Somebody came and touched the hem of my garment. And it reached my soul, my spirit, my power. Left me and went into someone. I said, who touched? You don't question Jesus when he says, who touched me? You just start looking around and say, well, she looked like she needs some help. He looked like he needs some help. They look like they need some help. Master, I don't know, but if you figure it out, I'll get them here to you. Who touched me? Who? Who was it that came here that was so desperate that they reached out to touch me and it drew my power? Who? Who?
This ain't her story. This ain't her story. But that was a bad girl. She steps into somebody else's story, touches Jesus, pulls strength from him, confuses the disciples, Peter and them, and Jesus feels the sincerity of her touch. Beloved, I introduce to you a sincere woman who can draw strength from Jesus. Happy birthday. A woman and a girl.
And Jesus said, somebody hath touched me.
Jesus said, wait a minute. Now y'all getting it twisted. Y'all doing too much. Don't look at your neighbor, but put your hand in the air and say, y'all doing too much. Because I don't want you to get in a fight, so. Jesus said, y'all doing too much. Hold up. I just told you that somebody touched me. Now, even if I didn't spell it out to you in particulars, my inference is this was no ordinary touch. You gotta know what Jesus is saying. And you gotta be able to follow the movement of Christ. Remember the man that was on the porch and he said, there is none to put me in the water. And Jesus was up there and he told him to take up his bed. He was waiting for an angel to come trouble the water and somebody to take him in the water. But when you have direct contact with Jesus, you better just touch the hem of his garment and know and believe in faith that his power is going to come in and heal any issue you got from the day you were born to the day you touch Jesus. You better ask him. You better hold on to him. You better do a Jacob. I won't let go. If I get a hold to Jesus and his garment, I won't let go. Until he bless me. What am I saying to the body of Christ? You have so much energy for other things. You want to do this and you want to do that.
My God, come on.
Talk about it.
Have that same energy when you reach and grab Christ.
Come on now.
And Jesus knew he was trying to get smart. Jesus knows when you're trying to get smart. He knows when you got an attitude, too. He said, reach him, tell him about it. He's a Bible scholar. We can't say stuff in here.
For I perceive that virtue.
Jesus said, I perceive. I know in the most depth part of my knowledge and in myself that this wasn't an ordinary touch. Now, how's your perception? Are you able to perceive?
Come on.
Go ahead. Read that perception from there.
For I perceive that virtue is gone out of me.
Now, see, something left me.
Yeah.
And I want to believe in my mind that there Jesus taught a little less. Mm-hmm. He teaches us the difference between the anatomy of touch. There's one touch when I can touch your skin. You feel me touching your hand and it's okay. But there's another touch where I grab you and I hold you and I don't let you go. I admit it, I couldn't touch anybody else but you. I'm a relative. I'm not worthy.
Yes, Lord.
I know I'm not worthy.
Yes.
But I need you. I know I'm worthy, God. But it's me that pulled on. I don't care what your issue is, man or woman. Pull on Jesus. Touch the hem of his garment. Bible says she was terrified. The word says, in the end, every knee will bow. But her end was there. She needed a happy birthday. She needed to be born again, rejuvenated, brought back to life, restored by the Master, by the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, our healer, our deliverer, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Shalom, El Shaddai, Elohim, Elohim, Jesus, Christos. She needed him. In a bad situation and you at your wit's end, you have his permission to interrupt somebody else's story. Beloved, today you can interrupt someone else's story, because Jesus is omnipresent, which means he can be present here with us, and then he can be present with somebody in Zimbabwe, and then he can come back to Europe and be present there, and he can be at a church 10 miles from here, but sitting in here, he's omnipresent. Then he's omniscient, meaning he knows all. He knows what's going on. So he can be dealing with a situation up on the other side of Lumberton, go down through Fairmont, come back into Roland, and then go back up 95. He knows. Somebody tell your neighbor. Go on and tell him, because he already knows. Go on and pull on him, because he already knows.
Free shell. She declared unto him before all the people for what cause she had touched him.
She said, it was me, Lord. It was me that touched you. But I needed to touch you because I'm bleeding. I'm bleeding. I've been bleeding for 12 years. Stuff happened to me a long time ago that began to open up my capillaries, my veins, my arteries, and in my spirit, in my physical. I've been bleeding for a long time. People have hurt me. They've wiped their hands on me. I'm sorry, but it was me. I had no other choice. I know you're going somewhere. But God, it's me. It's me. I need you.
And how she was healed immediately.
She said, God, when I touched the hem of your garment, I didn't want to really touch you because they called me unclean, so I just touched the hem of your garment. And when I did it, I felt power leave you and come into me. And I got what I've needed for 12 long years. I'm sorry, but I needed you. Rachel.
And he said unto her,
listen, listen, listen. Listen to what he said. Now, when we started out, she was the woman with the issue of blood. Read it, Shells, for when he said.
And he said unto her, daughter.
Wait a minute, Jesus. I'm not talking about Buddha. I'm not talking about Muhammad. I'm talking about Jesus. I'm talking about the one who left divinity and came into humanity. I'm talking about the one that traded his crown with diadem of jewels and traded it for thorns for us. I'm talking about Jesus. Jesus, Christos, El Señor, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. last time. I think.
And he said unto her, daughter, be of good comfort.
She don't even know she does. She know not to read through that part. Like.
Oh God.
How from the touching the hem of his garment to him asking who did it and to him looking down, did her name change? Wow. And got a new birth certificate. Her daddy didn't have to sign his name on the line. Jesus did. She's no longer woman. She's daughter. You're no longer woman. Happy birthday. Your daughter. Show me that blank spot on your birth certificate and I'll show you who your daddy is. He'll sign his name. You ain't got to cry no more. Don't worry about him. He'll sign. Yes.
Be of good comfort.
He said, honey, don't worry about it. It's my pleasure. He says, it's my good pleasure. Don't worry about it. My name is on you. Wait, I'm sorry. I did make a clause for.
Be of good comfort.
He said, be of good comfort. Mm-hmm. Don't even be stressed out about it.
That's right.
Look at your neighbor and say, don't even worry about it.
Don't even worry about it.
That's the wrong neighbor because they're trying to talk to you. Look at the other neighbor and say, don't even worry about it. Don't say worry, say don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. How you did that thing? That's how you do it. Don't worry about it. I want a thing. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Y'all ain't got no fan, it's okay. But if you got a little piece of paper of fan, you ought to say don't worry about it. The next time somebody come and ask you about your identity, ask you who you are, how you know you were called, who called you, when they called you. Who your daddy, where he live at, what's his name, did he have any children? You know we got to go back to Lumberton.
Thy faith has made thee whole. Go in peace.
Hold on. She's trying to read. She's ready to go. She's ready to see Junior. But anyway, read it one more time.
Be of good comfort.
Be of good comfort. Don't you worry about it. In other words, he pats her on the back.
Yeah.
And her name has changed. She's not woman anymore. She's daughter. You're not man anymore. You're son. And you done learned how to tell people, don't worry about it. And what does that say, Shell?
Thy faith has made thee whole.
The faith, the strength, the power, the trust, the belief that you had when you touched me, that you knew that I was going to be the one could end it all. That great power that's in you, that essence that came from your very center that reached out of you and touched me, touched my spirit, your spirit, and my spirit joined, and it made you whole. You might have came in fragmented, but you want to leave whole in the name of Jesus. Every pre-piece that has been broken, every every piece that has been left here, there, and everywhere. I call them forth in the name of Jesus, and I decree and declare to you, son, daughter, that faith has made you whole. But like I said, this ain't her story. Greenfield.
Go in peace.
Said, now you can only go in peace. What did he say?
While he yet spake.
While he was talking. That mean they ain't say, excuse me enough. While he was talking, look, you're going to tell you what happened.
There cometh one from the ruler of the synagogue's house, saying to him, thy daughter is dead. Trouble not the master.
Somebody came from the house and said, don't even worry about it. But that was wrong to worry about it. She died. While he was healing this woman, while he was held up, she died. The daughter is gone. She lived. Well, this is where the believer begins to see that Jesus is no ordinary man. He is God in three persons, blessed Trinity. So then he begins to speak. What do you say, Shells?
But when Jesus heard it, he answered him, saying, fear not, believe only, and she shall be made whole.
This is what I want to tell you. Fear not.
Fear not.
What else?
Believe only.
Believe only. Don't fear, don't worry about what the people around you are saying. Because the people around you don't have the faith that you have. They don't have the belief that you have. They don't have the experience that you've had with me. Fear not, believe only, and
she shall be made whole.
And she shall be made whole. And then from that point, it forces Jairus to say, and those around him, how is he going to make a dead girl whole?
Come on.
The breath has left her lungs. There is no heartbeat. They said, don't worry. Take your time and do whatever you got to do. Because she's dead. She's gone. But Jesus, the King of Kings, he commands a certain presence. You don't tell him what to forget. I healed this daughter. I took her from woman to daughter, and I'm going to heal this little girl. Rachel.
And when he came into the house,
he went into the house. You got to let Jesus in your house.
Yeah.
If you really want it, you got to let him in you.
He suffered no man to go in.
He told everybody else, don't you? That's right, get out. Why? Because your faith ain't there. He told everybody else, look here, y'all gonna leave. Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it. I got it.
Save Peter and James and John.
I just need three people to come in here with me. Peter, James, and John. That's all I need. Everybody else, so long, bye-bye. Why? He needed people with him. He needs people with her that believe. What happened here, Shams?
And the father and the mother of the maiden.
And the mama and the daddy came up. Because one thing about it, most mamas and daddy ain't going to give up on their child. Not only in the physical, but in the spirit. You might say, my blood mother gave up on you, but I bet your spiritual mama ain't going to give up on you. Go ahead, Shell.
And all wept and bewailed her.
They started crying all over. Oh, she ain't breathing. Her lungs ain't rising. I don't feel no breath coming out of her. Oh, my goodness. This might be a lost cause. But then those with faith were praying in the name of Jesus. Yes. Father, come. You created her lungs. You created her heart. Do spiritual resuscitation on her. Do it in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. And then what happened, Shell?
But he said, weep not.
He said, don't even cry about it. Don't cry about it.
She is not dead, but sleeping.
She's just sleeping. She's taking a nap. Somebody thought you were dead, but you were not. They thought you were dead, but you were just taking a nap. See, the thing about a nap is you can sleep so like you're not great. I'm not dead. Oh, I thought you was locked up and you wanted to never get out. I just took a little break. They said you had left town and you lost everything you had. No. That was physical stuff, but honey, in the spirit, I wish you could count up what God has given. Breeze fields.
And they laughed him to scorn.
They started laughing. That thing was funny to them. Why? Because they cannot believe the magnitude, the strength of our Lord and Savior. Go ahead, Shields. We got to finish this up.
Knowing that she was dead.
They just knew she was dead. But you have to have the right knowledge. Because sometimes what you think you know, you don't know. You got to filter it and send it through Jesus Christ. Like I might think that I know that I'm not going to be able to fulfill my financial obligations, but let me go check with Jesus. Jesus, are we going to be able to do that? Yes. You tell the bill collector, yes, we are going to be able to fulfill it. They say, well, give me the check now. You say, wait, I'm taking a little nap. When I wake up, I'll have it for you. You fall on your knees and you go into prayer and you pray until you fall asleep or pray until he.
Yeah, and he put them all out and took her by her hand and called, saying, Maid, arise.
Another version says, he takes her by her hand and says,
we're talking about a woman and a girl, right?
Yeah. Talitha Kumen. Talitha Kumen. Girl, come forth. And what happened, Shales?
And her spirit came again.
In the name of the Father. In the name of the Son. In the name of the Holy Ghost. And her spirit came again. It is the spirit, the pneuma, that God breathed into Adam, the breath of life. He breathed the breath of life into the little girl. I came to talk about a woman. Who was bleeding and he stopped it. A girl who was dead and he breathed the breath of life. Happy, happy birthday, a woman and a girl.
Thank you. Thank you.
about Melania. Melania hears God, and she hears him clearly. When you were pregnant with her, he had communion with her. She hears God. Melania, you hear God and know God. She knows his voice better than some of us know his voice. Evangelist Baker, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. To my hot sauce friend, he knows what I'm talking about. You are a great man of God.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Few compared to you. You're not proud. You're a humble man.
Yes, he is. That's right.
Who loves the Lord. May the mercy of God be your portion. May the mercy of God be your portion. And may you show men, young men, how to navigate through their life. And he really loves you. And he believes in you. Even when those who you thought should have believed in you,
come on here,
did he believed in you? He believed in you. He believed in you. And he gave you a father by the name of Apostle, and he loved. When you got a good day, you want to love it. Go show him some love. Don't worry about nobody. Go show him some love. Now, as you walk, everything is falling off. This is a rebirth.
We'll be right back.
Come on, saints, clap your hands and tell the Lord thank you. Come on, why God is moving, he's gonna be coming down to your road. Come on, praise him, thank him. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, open your mouth and praise him. Come on, open your mouth and praise him. Praise him. Hey, praise him. Thank you for doing it. Thank you for doing it. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name, Jesus. Come on, God is still speaking. He is still moving. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, I hear the chains falling. Come on, I hear the chains breaking. Yeah, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Come on, God is answering your prayers. Come on. He has heard you, come on. He came to see about you today. Yes, Lord. Speak, Lord, speak. Hey. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Jesus. Hey, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, pull on them. Pull on the anointing. Hey, pull on the anointing. Thank you, Jesus. Do it for me, Lord. Do it for my brother. Do it for my sister. Come on. Do it for my husband. Come on. Do it for my wife. Come on. Yeah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God is doing it. All you gotta do is just pull on them. Pull on them. Whatever you need is in the pool. Hey, whatever you need is in the pool. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, intercessors, pray for Pastor. Come on. Come on, intercede for her. Jesus. Jesus. Wonderful Jesus. Hey. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Glory, glory, glory. Oh, God is speaking. God is speaking. Hallelujah.
Everything down my road, come on. God is an answer to our prayers. Come on, somebody
Jesus. Oh yes, oh yes. Oh yes, oh yes. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.